Okay, we're back. I did pull a couple of greens. If you recall, we were working and talking about our clothes next. I pulled 1090 and 1005. So, let's see. Let's just do clothes. I know I had cap and clothes over here, but that's all right. 1090. And then I did 1005. And then I wanted some yellow to go in there too because I wanted browns. So what I did was I picked up my color wheel and I put the green arrow, I mean the orange arrow right there on the green. And I said, okay, my greens are more these. Do you see how that's got a little number on it? Okay, that's the best it's probably going to do for you focusing because it's focusing on everything else. It's a little six and a little seven. So then I take and I go over here. Number six and seven are these two. So I pulled my brown and my yellow ochre. So one of the browns that we used a while ago, 941, the yellow ochre is actually 942. And then I was like, okay, I really need a third color because there's quite a bit of clothing and pattern. So then I looked at those and went across, and it's this purple, this really deep purple. Now, this is where you have to just trust the color wheel and say, okay, we're going to go for it. So then I went into my purples and I did end up pulling black grape, which is 996. It's really dark, so we're going to have to be careful using it. And then number 932. And I think that with these colors now, it's really going to give us what we want for doing this. And we know what we can always adjust along the way. I was just sharpening that a bit real quick. So now we're going to come in with these colors, and I'm going to put them with their pairs. And I generally do the darkest on the right, the lightest on the left. So the lightest of each set is on the left. Now we're going to have to figure out what we want to do. Do I want to do each little stripe in her pants, or do I want to do it tone on tone? And I'm thinking I would like to see that tone on tone. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this green. All right, now watch first because you may not like this. And I'm going to do her pants. Now, what I mean by tone on tone is there is a plaid going through these. I am going to come back with the other green and do those stripes for the plaid. Okay, so I didn't go real dark on that. Now, I am going to get a little darker right up here because her sweater is coming down over the edge. And I can actually add a little bit of that green in a little bit right there too. In fact, I'm wondering if I just want to leave her pants like that, but no, I'm going to go ahead and plaid them up. So come through here and get your plaid going on. Yeah, I'm not doing just a whole lot of blending down here. It's not that big of an area. And I don't want it to get too busy. So I'm thinking if I just do plaid, that's probably going to be busy enough for this area. Okay? If she'd been full body and shown all of her pants or skirt or whatever she's in, I might not have even done the two colors. I'm not real sure. It's not something I have to decide. So, but I do like the tone on tone now that I'm doing it. It's not real busy. I am going to come through here with just a little bit of this green. Can you hear? I'm barely touching the paper. Just barely going across there. And I'm just going across that first row. I'm not even going to worry about blending it, because what I did was made a little shadow from where the sweater is overhanging. All right, now what else? I would like to do the stripes. Okay, I need to do that yellow so that it doesn't streak later and pick up the green. So I'm gonna put the green back, and I am going to do what yellow? I don't want to do her whole sweater because she's got the hair and the yellow's already going on. So I think what I'm gonna do is come in and do the stripes here. I'm sorry, I have to do it where I'm comfortable coloring. Let me turn it a little more. And then I'll just sit a little sideways. It'll be fine. Okay, I'm just coming right down through the middle of this. This is the band on her sweater. And I know it means it would make sense to do the sweater in this color. No, my yarn shop, they changed colors, and so they put this gold band on there. Yeah, just make it up as we go. All right, then I'm going to come over here and do this band over here the same way. Just going to come through the middle. I'm going to go around those buttons. I will probably use a metallic on those after a while. We'll just have to wait and see what we're feeling when we get to them. And yes, I did get in there just a bit. So I'm going to go ahead and erase that. Erase it when you do it. You won't accidentally color over it later. Okay. Now I'm going to come in with that brown. And I'm going to do the edges. Because this is where it's tucked under. So I want it a little darker there. It's also wrapped around her arm. Now this is wrapped on top, so it really could be that it's lighter where the light's hitting. Remember when we did the tree, the light was hitting? So let's pick up this really bright yellow from earlier. It's 915, and let's just do that top area. What we did was just gave it a little bit of light. Okay, now this, I'm going to go ahead and brown circles back to that brown we were using because it's kind of tucked up under again. Now I'm going to come back to this and I'm going to tone that down a little. And do you see I'm also going into that brown and I'm blending. And this does match her hair a lot. So if you're not comfortable with that, then you change your colors up. I'm okay with it because I have dark hair and it doesn't mean I don't wear dark colors. Okay. So now I'm going to do the same thing all the way across here. Let me get some circles going on. And if you want to, just write down where we are on this YouTube video. And you can do all of the rest of her and then go back to this area and put in whatever colors you like. Okay, you don't have to do it in the order I'm doing it. But if you want to find it later, it might be in your best interest to go ahead and write down the number of where we are on the video. Okay, say like we're almost 10 minutes in. I am going down the sides a little here because that makes it look more rounded. Remember, like we did up here, want it to round around, yeah, right. And then I'm going to come back in and I'm going to start blending all this together. Yeah, usually I would say go up and down, because the stripes are up and down, but that's such a little area that I'm just going to go ahead and go around her waist. Actually, I think that would be more of her hips. That, and so we're going to go around. Somebody was asking if I could do some coloring on the purse or carry along coloring book that Hannah has, and I do not own that, so at this time that's a negative. In fact, I don't own anything else besides this coloring book, so y'all let me know if there's something else. I am in touch with Hannah. I'm trying to find out if she has anything new coming out, because I know we want to keep going in the spring with some of these. Now, I know that's not the right color, but I just saw big old chunks of white right there, and I know I used this in there somewhere, so I just went ahead and did the touch-up. Okay, now I do like that. And then, let's see, what else shall we do in this color? I think I'm going to have her gloves and hat, possibly a different color. I'm not sure yet. So, now let's go back to our green. Yeah, let's go to our green. I am going to use the greens around all these little bits. Okay, so just get in there. And if you go over the top of this or this, these, don't worry about it. Unless you're going to come back in with pencil later, I'm coming in with gel pen later to do that. So, and I know my gel pen will go over the top of these, so I'm not too worried about it. I'm getting this band on. This will help pull her pants and top together, because we're repeating the color. We want it to look like a little matched outfit. Again, unless you don't care, then do whatever it is you'd like to do. Totally up to you on colors. Now, I do have the darker. We want that arm to look rounded. So we're going to go darker right here. If you remember, if you were with me when we did the little fairy with the mug of hot chocolate, that mug, we made it look rounded. We made the candy cane look rounded, the peppermint stick. That's all done by shading the outside edge of whatever it is we're working on. So we're working on this outside edge. And then we'll come back in with the lighter one and blend. Just blend that. And we can leave it lightest in the middle. It's fine. That's what we want. All right. So that should look now like it's rounded. Okay? All right. So that's finished. Let's put a dark stripe, and I am going to do the whole thing dark, just because I'm repeating the dark stripe that is down here in her pants. Okay? Does that make sense? Just repeating. And you know what I just thought about? Everybody has matching sleeve. We need to go over here. Earlier, we had done the little deer, but now we need to do the rest of this. What I'm going to do is just come in here and lightly put that green in there, okay? Because her arm is actually coming around, because here's her other glove. So we're going to say that's it, and then the rest of this is this area, okay? And then it disappears behind the tree and comes out down here. Okay, so that's all we really needed to do. I'll put a touch of light in there, but it doesn't really matter. It's not showing that much and it's off in the distance. Now the purple. Are you scared yet? Okay, I am going to do all of this in purple. Yeah, I am. The color wheel said it would work. It's going to work. We're going to go for it. So I'm going to start light. I'm going the direction that her arm is going. It's not going to matter in the long run because I'm going to come back in with circles and blend it. But I'm just trying to get some initial color on this. I did run this off on cardstock that I got it Tuesday morning. I will not be doing that again. The cardstock, it's okay. I mean, it is cardstock, but it's not got the tooth that the cardstock at the craft stores have. So I do get asked that quite often as to what paper. And I know Michaels now has a new Recollections cardstock slab. I think it's 50 sheets for $2 all the time. And I will probably be getting that next time and try it out and see what I think of it. Okay, this is going to end up being a lot darker before I'm finished, but I'm just getting that first coat on. You can see all the white that's sticking up, so this does have some tooth to it. I'm debating on this band if I want to make it green and if I want to make all this in here green. Haven't decided yet, so leaving it alone. I'm just getting this initial purple in there. And in fact, we might even make that purple. Just not sure. Do what you want. I am just here for guidance and to listen to you say, but I can't do that. Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can. I mean, look how far we've come. Would you have thought your tree was going to look like that? You know, we were doing it, and then all of a sudden I was like, oh, add light to the top, dark to the bottom, and look how dimensional your tree looks now. Yeah, it looks good. And it's okay to say that your work looks good. You know, and when somebody says it looks good, don't go, oh, no, no. Yeah, say thank you. There's nothing wrong with that. There's a difference in being modest and then just carrying on like that. Because really, when you carry on, it just makes people say it even more. So I just, oh, thank you, and go on. And see, I do like the purple, so trust your color wheel. All right, now I'm going to start coming in with my dark. And we're not even at 20 minutes in yet, so we're doing good. Now, this is really dark, so I've got to be careful. Can you hear it scratching? That's because there's not as much pigment in this as there is in the lighter. Now, here's the question. You want this dark because it makes her arm look wrapped. But this is on bottom, so it should be darker. What do you do? All right. We're going to come up through here and do this dark. Okay. Just like what we normally would have done. Going around the curl. We're going to take each section as it comes. Okay. Got that dark. Now I'm going to come back with my original purple. This is actually called violet. And I'm going to blend. Okay. So now that's not very dark. I'm going to come back in and make it darker because I do want that to look like it's somewhat recessed around. And what I might have to do is grab a lighter purple to help us out a bit. So that looks like a good one. 10008. It's right here. It's Parma. Just in the middle. Okay, do you see that? That kind of fixed it. I just did a little bit just there in the middle, and I'm not sure it's going to show up on camera for you. So we're going to add that to our list of colors. 008. Now, when I take my dark, okay, lay these down, that's just too much. When I take my dark and come in here, I am not going to blend it with the light. I'm going to leave it dark, I think. And now that looks a little more recessed in there. And this is on top. Does that make sense? It is tricky working with dark colors, yes. So, and because this is all getting so dark, I'm wondering about that little neck scarf area already. Just not sure yet. So, unsure? Don't do it. This does look like the side of her sleeve, though, on her shoulder. So I am going to go ahead and do that. Triangle's dark. Then come back in and blend. Okay. So let's go ahead and do some more of the darks here. Dark down this side. I don't think I'm going to do dark here and here. I will do dark here because it's rolling around. We'll do some here, but not as dark. And really on the top of that shoulder, we can do light. And then fade it with our little circles. The reason being that light's coming down. So there actually could have been a little bit of light there. And now we're just going to blend it all. Just blend everything with that violet. And again, if you want to go with standard red and green, if you want to put her in blue, you do whatever you want. I like to think outside the box. I like to experiment with color. This is a runoff page. I can always run it off and do it again. So what better way to actually practice some of those things than to get in there and just do it? Even though that light was up there, I'm still going to blend it with this. Just blend it all. You see how that shoulder looks a little lighter just on the top? And again, you may not be seeing the colors the way I am, because of the camera and the lighting in here. But I'm liking that pretty good. All right, let's finish shadowing down here. Get some shading done. Okay, this is down on the bottom, so it will be darker also, and that darkness may even come up a bit. All right. Yeah, that's good. Let's go ahead and now just blend all that in together. Do you remember how I went in and put a little bit of light there? Let's do that here before we get too far along. We put some up there. Let's just put some right here on our arm. Just to help bring that color in other areas. And then right here. There we go, because we wanted it to accept the color. And if I had done all the darker purple first, or this purple in my hand, the medium color that we're using, then there might not have been any tooth left in my paper to accept that color, if that makes sense to you. Okay. Yeah, I do not do these pages up ahead of time and pick colors and all that without you and do a whole layout. I what you see is what I'm doing for the first time. So, and then ovals to blend that. Blending that. Yeah, from where I'm sitting, this is looking just fine. Now, I will put a little dark in that little V area, and a little here, and a little here, just to add a little bit of depth, and then just blend away. Just keep blending. Okay, just keep blending those colors. I think we're going to have just enough time to go ahead and put in, remember, the rest of the sleeve. And that's all we're going to do on that because it's way back there. Now we're going to do dark here. We're going to do dark here and then fade it as we come in. Because we want her to look rounded. All right, so fade this a little as we come in. And all of this is going to be darker because it's overcast by her hair, her arm, her hand, everything. So this is more in the shadows. Just going to bring that down. Bringing that color down in here. I will make sure that I do some blending with circles. Okay, I'm gonna have to turn. I've gotta go the direction that's comfortable for my hand instead of for your eye. And then right down through here. All right, now see how that's already darker? Now I will come in with just the Violet 932 and do all this blending. And then I'll take the tissue that we have, the Kleenex, and I will rub across this to get all the wax markings going in one direction. Down. I don't know how much in the camera I am with all my pencils waving around. You're leaned in watching. Don't need to stab you in the eye with a pencil. I know it was a stupid joke, but still. Gotta do something besides just sit here and color. All right. So there's that. We are almost out of time. Let's take our tissue and do the rub. Why rub? Because do you see all those marks? That kind of nasty looking? I mean, really. So take a clean part. I'm not trying to get into the green or anything else or that yellow, just doing the purple. Just buffing through there. Now, do you see how much better that looks? Yeah, there's that one line right there. Yeah. I can just rub again and that's gone. Doesn't that look better? Yeah, so anytime you get all that streakage and you need to, just rub it out. Yeah. Soft tissue, no aloe or anything on it. Not a napkin. I think that's going to have a little bit too much coarseness in it. But anyway, okay, when we come back, I'm thinking maybe green here. We'll see. And we're going to finish this and work on our mittens and hat. So I'll see you back in a bit.